Well, it happened about 2 years ago in late 2010 when I met Tori's trainer, mm-hmm. manager, boxer, aficionado, Craig Flatiger. He was doing some work for me. He does contracting work. And we got to talking, and he told me about Tori and her great story. And I felt it was a great idea, being a filmmaker, to kind of kill two birds with one stone, and that was to not only help Tori and get her story out, but also to help tell her story, make a documentary, which is something I had never done before.
Okay. To add to that, Tori, as the project was coming together, was there any, you know, initial reservations as to doing a documentary, you know, something that's a little more personal as opposed to, you know, something that's a little different? Were you always on board, or was it something that you had, you know, reservations about?
We thought about doing one before, but we didn't do it until he came along with the idea, and we was like, okay, yeah, works for me.
Okay. Well, this is actually to both of you guys. Thus far, what has been? Well, maybe I should ask you, Jeff, because I was, you know, speaking with you a little earlier. I know, you know, things are, you know, hectic with you, Tori, so you didn't really have a chance to see it in its entirety until today. So, Jeff, what's been the reaction thus far, you know, with the film?
Very positive. Again, we're helping to get Tori's name out there because, again, women and boxing don't really mix. It's not that popular here mm-hmm. in the United States. Yes, it is in Europe. A little more so in Bermuda yeah. and the islands.
In the different countries, they really support their female boxers. But in the United States, we don't get the backing or the support that the males get. And, I mean, we're trying to fight for it. But, like I said before, we do just as much, if not more, than what they do. And we do all this training while we're still raising kids. You know, most guy boxers, when they have, you know, a fight and they prepare for a fight, they leave their families. But we as females, we can't. We don't have that privilege. But, I mean, I just feel that we do more, but we don't get recognized for it.
Okay. Well, to add to that, have there been any, you know, interesting stories that you've had in terms of reactions from people that have, you know, had a chance to see the film?
Well, a lot of people wonder, how can she do it all? I mean, it's a testament to what, you know, Tori mm-hmm. Nelson is all about. As it states in the film, she's up at 6 in the morning, and some nights she's going to bed at 2 o'clock in the morning, getting 4 or 5 hours of sleep. Oh. You know, she works in what has been termed the richest county in the nation, which is Loudoun County, Virginia. And you have to wonder, well, why do you live there? Why do you work there? And I think it goes back, and I don't want to speak for you, but it goes back to your kids and providing them an education that they might not otherwise receive anywhere else.
Exactly.
But to do that, she's got to work 3-4 jobs that aren't the best paying jobs.
No.
And that get you up early and keep you up late. So mm-hmm. that's a testament to Tori and her character.
Okay. Well, actually, I have a little sidebar for you, Tori. Being that, you know, the subject of the documentary is about boxing, you know, there's been a lot of buzz thus far in terms of girl fighting. So I guess the question I have is, have you been following Ronda Rousey at all and, you know, her story?
No, with the UFC? I've heard of her. I've heard of her, but I haven't followed her story. I haven't.
Okay. Well, do you have an idea of, you know, what the whole, you know, story is in that regard with her joining the UFC? I mean, even if you haven't, I mean, is there what do you think about, you know, that particular idea of having a woman join the UFC in terms of mixed martial arts?
I love it. I salute her. You know, more power to her. I feel that we shouldn't be, because we're females, we shouldn't be excluded from anything. If we can have babies, We can do anything.
Sure.
I don't see any men pushing out no babies.
Sure.
So I don't see why we should be, you know, limited to whatever we do.
Okay. Well, final question for you guys. I know you said that you had a couple of fights that you have coming up. Can you go into a little detail of, you know, the upcoming matches that you do have?
Yes, I have a fight coming up in January. I'll be going back to Bermuda for the WBC, WIBA, and WBO, I believe, title belts. And then after that, we'll see where my manager takes me after that. But we focus on one at a time. We don't ever overlook anyone. We take one fight, and we serious on that one fight. And then after I win that one, then we go to the next.
Okay. And Jeff, is the next project that you're working on, will it be a documentary, or are you thinking about something that's a full-length feature?
Not so much the documentary. I think working on Tori's project, because it's such a large, big commitment, again, it takes away from my family. I did this mm-hmm. part-time. It took me a year and a half to put it together, evenings, weekends, and such. And then, of course, we had to wait for the fight, wait for the next mm-hmm. fight. And yeah. In some cases, that's months and months and months apart. Got some promises in 2013 for hopeful, television work.
Okay.
But nothing's written in stone as yet. But we keep our fingers crossed.
You got it. You speak it in your life, and you accept
right.
it.
Claim it.
We're working on it, just waiting for the logistics.
Okay. All right, then. Well, thank you for your time.
Nice
thank you, Tori.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff.
All right. Thanks for having us.
No problem.